Hey, everybody, I'm Phil Town from Rule One Investing, and today I want to talk to you about six great financial goals that you should make for 2019. Now, as a reminder, make sure you click the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notifications when I release new videos. And also, whenever I'm talking about goals, I want to make sure we understand that the really major things we're trying to do in our life, particularly in this world we're in, to try to become financially independent, to try to become financially free, I don't think having a goal of doing that is going to be sufficient. I think what you have to do is make a promise to yourself. Goals can be really a problem. So we're going to talk about goals today, but I want you to realize that goals can also be kind of intentions that make you maybe kind of take you off the hook of actually trying to get done what you're trying to get done. So for example, if I say, it's my goal to see you at dinner tonight at 6, you kind of know there's a good chance I won't be there, right? Because a goal is kind of like an intention. And you got to remember the old saying that the road to hell is paved with good intentions. So one of the problems we have with goals is I've got a goal to lose weight, a goal to stay in shape, a goal to do this and do that. And it really kind of boils down to a bunch of intentions that we may or may not do. So what I want you to do is I want you to form these goals we're going to talk about around a very serious promise to yourself that you will achieve in a very specific amount of time. And the way I'd like to do it and the way I've done it in my life is just say, look, I'm going to make X amount of dollars in X amount of time, and I'm going to focus on that. I'm going to write that down as a promise and sign it and date it. And that's going to be a major focus of my life to get that done. So we can't make tons of promises, right? We have to have goals that will point us in the right direction, but start with a major promise about your finances that you're going to achieve. Now, if you want to achieve your goals, now these are the sub-goals that are going to take you on that route to your promise, right? So if the promise is, you know, you're going to cross the country from California to New York and you're going to end up in New York City in a year, then you're going to have goals to get there. I promise I'm going to be in New York in 1 year. And then my goals are I'm going to get to, you know, from Los Angeles to Las Vegas in a certain amount of time and so on. So goals are going to be these steps to get to this promise that we have of having a great financial freedom. So if we want to achieve these things, then first thing we have to do is we have to set them. Now, I know it's simple, right? It's simple, but it's really true. We obviously have to set these goals. You have to know what it is you want to achieve if you want to achieve it. And every high achiever and success guru focuses on this. Warren Buffett, Tony Robbins, my friend Brian Tracy, all these guys are going to tell you that goal setting is a huge part of their success. It's a big deal to be step by step to some really, really important final promise. Now, the key to setting goals is to make a habit of setting them and then revising them as you achieve them or as you fall short of them. I set new goals every year, every month, every week. Hey, I even look at my goals every day and review what it is I want to achieve that day. That's what allows me to spend time fooling around on my horses. When it comes to your finances, it's important that you get in the habit of setting annual goals. Everything we do with money revolves around a year. Like, what's our rate of return? That's a year. What's our compounded annual growth rate? That's a year. So spend time every year before the new year to determine what you want to focus on in the coming year. Now, to help get your finances on the right path, here are some clear financial goals that I recommend you set going into the new year. So first, I want you to set a budget. I love budgets. I'm really bad at them. Probably you are too. I know you don't want to hear this. It's just the way it works, but you have to set a budget, particularly if you really are struggling to get to a potentially great retirement. You've got to set a budget. It's the most important thing you can do. So no matter how much money or how little money you have, you set a budget. Here's what I would argue. I would argue that the less money you have, the easier it is to set a budget. Because trust me, when I was living off of $4,000 a year, I knew exactly where my money was going. You got to pay attention, right? if you're living in India trying to make $4,000 stretch, you got to pay attention. So having no money actually taught me how to manage my money. So wherever you are in your financial journey, this first step is essential. So budgeting is the key to getting control of your finances. A budget is your map for financial accountability and responsibility. I know it doesn't sound fun, and it isn't, but setting a budget allows you to exercise discipline. And that's the key. When it comes down to how you spend your money, it's all about discipline. For instance, do you know how much money you're gonna put into necessities versus how much you're gonna put into savings? Well, it's gonna be very difficult to build wealth long-term if you don't know, right? So budgets are actually paths to financial freedom. By managing your money, you can control how and when you are able to reach your other financial goals and ultimately that financial promise you're making to yourself. Second, make a savings goal for yourself. Once you've set a budget, it's time to set a savings goal for this year. Your savings goal should be attainable, but it should also be as aggressive as you can manage. I like to say you should put away 10% of every paycheck so you never even see it. Just pay yourself first so that you never even have to think about it. And then figure out how to live on the rest of it and adjust your budget accordingly. Remember, the more you save now, the more the money will multiply or compound in the market as kind of time rolls along. It's incredibly important to understand the power of compounding on the money you save now. Also, it's important to put aside your savings money first before you pay anything else. If your savings are the first part of your budget that you pay, they'll be much less likely to get left out. Just pay yourself first, budget off the rest. Third, I want you to pay off bad debts. So the only financial goal more important than saving and investing is saving and paying off bad debts. Now, bad debts are a particular kind of debt. They're debt that is carrying a very high interest rate, like 18% interest, 15% interest, that could easily end up being what you're paying on your credit cards. Get rid of those, because making 15 to 18% a year is fantastic investing. So if you can just pay down 18% credit cards, that's as if you're making 18% a year as an investor. Now, there is good debt. Good debt is the kind of debt you incur when you're investing in something, when it's about to produce it's an asset that produces a great return. So for example, if you were to borrow money to put into a house, that might be really good debt because you might get a great return on that investment. Also, investing in a college education, investing in a high school education is fabulously good debt, right? So debt for education that's gonna benefit you by making you more productive, that making you more money, is good debt. Bad debt, when you go out there and charge stuff to impress people you don't know, who don't care about you anyway, that is the worst kind of debt in the world. So stop doing that. So high interest bad debt, such as credit cards, they work exactly the opposite of good investment. They're gonna decrease your net worth rather than grow it. So paying off debts such as these should be your first priority. And this year is as good a time as any to become debt-free of bad debt. Now next, get your credit in check. So start the year off right by getting a handle on what your credit score is and the factors that affect it. If your credit score ends up being lower than you would like it to be, then take some steps to improve it. So pay off debt and keep the balances on your credit cards low. That works pretty good to getting a better credit score. Here's some things that knock your credit score down you might not realize. When you go out and think about applying for an automobile loan or something, and maybe you go to two or three places, those will tank your credit score if they run those credit score checks. So be careful when you do a credit check through somebody you want to buy something from, particularly something big like an automobile, that you ask them if they're going to do it in such a way that it's going to hurt your credit score. Now next, set a goal to get your taxes done early. Like it or not, tax season always comes up quicker than you think. Each year, far too many of us make the mistake of waiting until the last minute to get your taxes organized. Let me tell you about a horror story. All right, Melissa and I always waited till the last minute. Our accountant, our CPA would handle it, and they would take care of things, and then the last minute they would turn them in. And a few years ago, they shifted from paper to digital tax filings, and our guy had to sign our documents and then he submitted them digitally. That meant a signature went in that was digital. 3 months later, right, after the time when you're supposed to have done your taxes, he gets a notification that we haven't filed our taxes yet. And the reason is because we have not signed them. So we needed to sign them apparently in ink and have the IRS have the original. So we signed a document in ink and sent that in. They lost it. 3 months later, we find out they still think we haven't paid our taxes. We sign another digital document. They lost it. We send it in another digital document. We don't hear anything back. We think everything's all right. Fully a year later from the first letter, we get another letter that says, we have now been late in our taxes for over a year and we owe them $120,000 of penalties. Well, that's a pretty big shock, let me tell you. And so we start to fight this, right? We go to arbitration and we think we're in arbitration. Turns out we're not in arbitration, we're in collection. We don't even realize that for 6 more months. Then as we start to find out we're in collection, the person that's trying to collect the money from us at the IRS goes on maternity leave for 3 months. When she comes back, instead of talking to us, she simply filed a lien on our house. So you guys, this is crazy. I mean, we had the money to pay the taxes. So we run down to the IRS. We say, holy criminy, you guys just leaned our house. This is nuts. What are you doing? Oh, and by the way, they realized they'd made a mistake and they just avoided all of that, but they still had the lien on our house. So they said, well, you got to go down and pay this little bit. And we ran down to write a check to pay it. And they said they wouldn't take checks. We said, we'll give you cash. They said, we can't pay cash. We have to put you on a payment plan. I mean, this is, you can't make this stuff up. So here's the point. Avoid this stress and hassle that comes with waiting around to the last minute because things can happen. And set a goal to have your tax documents fully prepared as soon as possible. Get ahead of the game and don't let the bureaucracy give you a nightmare like it gave us. We got it all straightened out. We love the IRS. Hey, IRS guys, we know we need you. Not trying to knock you down or throw you under the bus, but it was a crazy time. Finally, take some time to research companies to invest in. 2019 might just be an amazing year to get amazing deals on really wonderful companies that you wouldn't be able to get at any other time in the last decade. That's why saving and getting your finances in order is so critical and so important. When the market drops and when it plummets, we want to be ready to take advantage of the fire sale on wonderful companies. So make it a goal to put at least 5 companies on a wish list in the next year. Now, I'd love to hear from you guys. Do you have your goals set for 2019? What are some of your goals? And what's your big promise? What are the thing you are going to do to get yourself financially free? Leave a comment below with your answer. I'll be sure to follow up with you. And thanks for watching. Now go play. If you enjoyed this video and you feel it was valuable in teaching you more about your financial goals, hit the like button and please share this video with your friends. And if you want more investing content, subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click the button on the screen for a free gift. Thanks again for watching.